Hey guys, in this video I am going to tell you how to rank your website or your article on the first page of Google or first page of any search engine. So if you currently have a blogging website or if you plan to start a blogging website, this video will help you to understand how to rank your articles. First of all, you have to find a sub niche. As example, if you write articles related to traveling, general traveling niche is highly competitive and there are a lot of websites already rank on traveling keywords or travel keywords. So as a beginner or as a new to blogging, if you try to write articles about traveling and rank those articles on search engines, that will really difficult because travel is highly competitive keyword. So if you plan to write articles about traveling, you have to find sub niche of traveling or sub niche of travel. As example, you can write articles about travel in specific or travel equipment or travel with pet partners or travel with specific vehicle. So you can find sub niches like this and write articles around those sub niches. After you find sub niche, you have to find low difficulty keywords around those sub niche. Actually, if you try to find long tail keywords, you will be able to find low difficulty keywords. You can find those low difficulty keywords using keyword researching tool like Ahrefs, Moz, or SEMrush. Those are the best keyword researching tool. Actually, Ahrefs is the most trusted and easy tool to find low difficulty keywords. However, try to find low difficulty keyword. Actually, I forget to explain about low difficulty keyword and long tail keyword. Basically, low difficult keyword mean keywords that has lowest competition. Long tail keywords mean long keywords that people consistently search. So most of time, those long tail keywords are the best keyword to write articles, because those long tail keywords don't have high competition. The second point is write SEO friendly, useful articles. So when you find a long tail keyword, you can write high quality articles that has high engagement. Basically, if you try to solve issues of your readers, your article engagement will increase and your article will rank on the search engine. So you can write long articles. Basically, if you can write articles that has words around 2000 to 3000 and if you write the quality content and useful content, readers will engage with your article and they will love to read your article. Also, you can add YouTube videos related to your article topic. As example, if you write article about travel with pet, you can find related videos on YouTube and add those videos to your article. Then you can mention the YouTube channel name and you will not get any type of issues with AdSense or any other way. This is the best way to keep the engagement. Also, it will help to reduce the bounce rate of your website. So if you have the lowest bounce rate, Google will notice it as the good sign. So you can check the bounce rate on Google Analytics. If your website bounce rate is really high, you have to consider about your article quality and try to modify it with adding quality content and adding YouTube videos. Also, when you write article, use SEO tool. If you use WordPress to build your website, you can use plugins like RankMath, Yoast SEO to make your articles SEO friendly. Basically, you will get indications or scores to your article. So if you can write article that has high score, you will able to create SEO friendly article without you know about it. The next point is increase the domain authority. So first, check the current domain authority of your website. To do that, go to Google and search something like domain authority checker. Then you will get result like that. So I will open this Moz result and Ahrefs result. Then paste your website URL here. I will paste my domain name or URL here and click on analyze domain. Then I got the details about domain authority. So currently my domain authority is 3 and it's really low number. Also I can check the rank in keywords and spam score. Basically, if you can increase the domain authority, you can easily rank your website on search engines. Also, if I check the same result on Ahrefs, I will get the result like this. So the number one method to increase your domain authority is build backlink. So there are few ways to build backlinks to your website. Basically, you can guest posting. That means you can write articles for other website and add your website URL in those articles. Also, you can get Web 2.0 backlinks by sharing your content on website like medium.com, wix.com or other blogging platforms and forums. So always try to find high quality domains and write articles for those domains. As example, before you write any article, you can check those domains name on Ahrefs and find the domain authority. In that way, you will be able to reduce your spam score. But if you try to create spammy backlinks, that will affect your domain quality. So the next point is check the website loading speed. Basically, majority of people come to your website with mobile phones and tablets. So if your website not load faster on the mobile phones or tablets, they will leave your website without waiting for few minutes to load your article, because there are a lot of content to get knowledge. As example, if you write travel in Italy, there are a lot of other writers or lot of resources to find information about travel in Italy. So you have to consider about the loading speed of your website. You can search on Google website loading speed test and you will get result like this. So you can go to Google page speed insight and GT matrix. In those websites, you can add your URL, then click on analyze. After this complete, I will add the URL here and test the website to find the speed of my website. Here is the result for my website. So in mobile version, it gets 51 of scores and I can check the issues of the website. Also, if I check on the GT matrix, it gets the A as desktop version. So validate your website speed on those website speed tester tools, and if it really low and if it take lot time to load your website speed, you can optimize your website speed by adding cache plugins and optimize the content and images. If you don't know about those stuff, you can hire a freelancer on Upwork or Fiverr and get their service to increase the speed of your website. So if you have really slow website, users will not stay on your website and it will affect your website bounce rate. So as I told before, Google will check on your website bounce rate, and if it really high, your website will not rank on the search engine. And finally, you have to be consistent, because blogging is not a short-term journey or easy way to make money. You have to be consistent and put lot of work to create and maintain high quality blog articles. Basically, try to share at least 2 articles per month. So when you share articles, write high quality articles and write high engaging articles. Lot of people try to share daily content on their website and they will never rank those articles on search engine, because the quality of those articles is really low and readers not engaging with those articles, and search engine will never rank those articles. So don't think about the quantity, always focus on quality and write high quality articles. Also, at least wait 2 to 3 months until your high quality articles rank on the search engine, because sometimes it will take time. So meantime, you can build backlinks and build email list to promote your article. So Those are the things you should consider when you try to rank your articles on search engines. So I am telling this information from my own experience, so you may know more ways to rank your articles on search engine. So if you know different ways, feel free to comment it and we can learn from those information. And I will see you in next time.